I think we need a new way of thinking about how the economy ought to grow. We're on the edge of a violent explosion. If you've been around as long as me, you'd know. I hate to fall into the bottomless pit of economics with this silly little rhyme. I'm just trying to get your attention while I steal a little bit of your time. You see, it's hard to write poems about the money supply and how capitalism is unstable. It's hard to explain the maldistribution of wealth to my Aunt Mabel. The economists disagree on almost everything, though they're all in favor of growth or the elimination of debt. But you see, you can't have both. And the earth is being trashed by an insatiable pursuit of wealth. You must see it's now or never. We have to rearrange the paradigm. We cannot grow forever. That's the bottom line. We have to change our way of thinking. We cannot bloat eternally without blowing up and sinking. The dollar once was worth silver and gold, and its problems were global and chronic. But now it's a promise from Washington, and the promise is just electronic. Flowing numbers into the accounts of the few, to billionaires to profit their cause, who sell us our goods, feed us ideas, who make our food and our drugs and our laws. Though I'd like to lay all the blame on them, beneath it all I see, like the bad penny of the boomerang, it all comes back to me. When international oil cartels spill millions of gallons of black sludge into the rivers, the oceans, the streams, over the neighborhoods, from capsized tankers, fallen derricks, leaking pipes, and the only punishment for the crime is the transfer of some electric numbers from one account to another, I drive my automobile by the spill to observe the damage. When emaciated children sit cross-legged, naked in the sand, covered with flies, racked with hunger, starving, not for the lack of food, but for an international banking system that controls the flow of money and determines that corn would be better made into gasoline than food to better fill the pockets of the farmers of Wall Street. I turn sadly away from the television, shed a tear, and continue to drop my scraps of leftover food into the disposal. When indigenous South American villages are displaced from their jungle huts by gigantic logging trucks which roar in and decimate ancient forests that their ancestors have inhabited for centuries, leaving them with a wasteland of stumps, I buy the wooden chairs and tables at my nearby superstore. When Chinese farm girls are crowded into hot, unsanitary factories to work 15 hours a day, then to sleep 20 to a room at night for 65 cents an hour with no music or bathroom break allowed, I demand ever lower prices on my computers and underwear. When the earth is all desert and the ocean is slime, I plead guilty to the crime.